Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the FL Studio series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/FL Studio. Today we're gonna guide you through your first track in FL Studio. So this will be a step-by-step process guiding you through your first track. Now in music production, there's a billion ways to do the same thing. Okay, so when you're getting overwhelmed, no worries, just go to BusyWorksBeats.com/beginners. We have a beginner's guide for free right there on that page. So firstly, let's open up our browser. We're gonna pick the ingredients for our song. Just like we're baking a cake, you need the ingredients first. You can't make cake out of nothing. So let's go to our browser. Let's go to packs. These are sounds provided by ImageLine. If you have the updated version, you're gonna have a folder called Drums by Mode Audio. So we're gonna search this folder first. Let's go to claps. Let's pick out a clap. A clap is like if you're clapping your hands, it's like a snare drum. I like that bright clap. Let's right click, open in new channel. That's gonna send it to the channel rack. So if we open up the channel rack, this is where our items are. Okay, this is where we stack the sounds that we import into our project. So we're gonna send that to track one. If you don't see that number on the left, hit Alt to hide or reveal that number. So let's grab one more clap. I like this one because it's nice and big. Let's right click and open a new channel. So now we have two hand claps. Let's send that to track two. So notice we're getting in the habit of giving everything its own mixer slot. So if you open up your mixer screen and I hit the clap, it plays on track two. So we can manipulate it, you know, based on the sample. So we have the first clap, track one, second clap, track two. So we can do separate things to them if need be. Let's close up the claps folder. Let's pick out some cymbals, if we even need any. I like this here. Let's right click, open a new channel. Send that to track three. And let's open that up. Let's right click, open a new channel. Now, I'm not sure if this track's gonna need so much cymbal work, but they're a good cymbal. So let me turn my headphones down a bit because that cymbal is loud in my headphones. Okay, so let's close up the cymbals folder. Let's go down to hi-hats. Let's grab a nice short hi-hat. Right click, open a new channel, send that to track five. So you can see we're getting in the habit of sending stuff directly to the mixer. The reason that's important is because you want to account for your sounds. Because mixing is the process of making your song sound better using a different process called mixing. In short, let's go to kicks. Now the kicks, I might not find the kick I'm looking for here, but let's see. They're all different types of kicks. This one's pretty cool. Let's right click, open a new channel. You can spend the time to go through all the kicks, okay? These are mostly dance style kicks. And let's go to snares, just in case you want to layer a snare over your claps. Let's go to snares. Now these are dance snares again. So some of these are not gonna match the genre that I have in mind. But here's one, let's open that up, snare 31. Let's right click, open a new channel. Again, get in the habit of sending these to their own mixer slots. It'll save you so much time later down the line. Okay, so that's all we need as far as drums. We don't wanna overkill the track, so let's close up the browser, collapse it. Now we need instruments. So we have a part of the ingredients, which are our drums. Now let's grab our instruments. Let's click the plus button so we can pull up our plugin list. I'm gonna stick with the plugins native to FL Studio. Let's go to GMS, which is the synth in FL Studio. Now, if you don't have the full version of any of these, it's okay. You can still use the synth to follow along. It just won't allow you to save the presets for the project. Let's go to banks, user. Let's go to default so we can reset the plugin from scratch. And it's just a sawtooth, which is a very common sound wave to be the initialized sound. So we're gonna synthesize a sound. Let's close out our browser by clicking the browser button. Let's open up a live instrument like FL Keys. This will be our keyboard. Send that to track nine. Just keep getting in the habit of sending everything to your mixer. That's the biggest lesson here. Let's turn down detune. And we can add effects to these sounds to make them sound cooler. Let's add another plugin, FL Slayer. For guitar, where are we at? Slayer. Here we go. Now, firstly, turn it off power mode. Go to solo fixed or solo dynamic. That way we can play one note at a time. If you go to power mode or power chords, it's going to play a power chord, which is really two notes. Okay, so that's the difference. Now we're just going to leave it as is. And the distortion that you hear is based on the stuff at the bottom. So we can always change that later. But now we have an electric guitar. Send that to track 10. So we have an electric guitar, we have a grand piano sound, we have a synth, and we have drums. So we can kind of start the track with those elements. We can always add stuff later. So let us start with the drum rhythm. So we need to turn on our metronome so we can hear the rhythm and hit play. Now the metronome is going to hit every beat of 140 BPM. So 140 BPM stands for beats per minute. So every time you hear the metronome, that's one beat. One, two, three, four. Now I like to have my channel rack set to 8 beats. So it's gray, red. That's 4 beats. One, two, three, four. Then another 4. One, two, three, four. Let's close up that last bit. And you can left click and drag however many beats you want in your channel rack. I like to have 8. So it's 1, it's gray, red, that's 2, gray, red, 2, gray, red, 2, gray, red, 2. Now don't worry about the grayed out area, okay? Don't. This is minutia. We can always add notes over here and it will unlock the screen. So don't worry about the grayed out part. So let's add a kick drum. Start with the kick and snare rhythm first, and let's slow the BPM down. Let's drag it down to about 90 or 88 BPM. So we're slowing the beat down. And here's where you can sequence your rhythm. Use the metronome. If your drums sound weird, always reference the metronome to help you with your rhythms. So the rhythm here is boom, boom, ch, boom, 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 ch. Very common rhythm. Okay, very dance-like. Let's add that to the playlist. Let's go to the playlist screen. Let's use our paint tool and just left-click pattern 1 into the playlist. If you don't see pattern 1, click here and select your pattern, or you could right-click on the pattern icon and select your pattern. So that is how you pick the pattern you want to insert into the playlist. Sounds a little like dancey, so let's go to the kick. This is a little more advanced, but if you turn up the out parameter, it will fade the kick out. So it's a little bit shorter instead of that long sample. Let's turn up that channel volume a bit. Let's turn up the kick. So I like to separate my drums. People like to layer everything in one pattern, and it gets really confusing when it comes to songwriting time. So if you get in the habit of going to new patterns, it's easier to arrange a song. So let's go to pattern 2. Let's add this into the playlist just by left clicking. If you don't see it, it's okay. Just go to a new pattern, left click. It will insert whatever pattern you're on into the playlist. This way we can hear pattern 2 in context. Now if you're not hearing the playlist screen, you want to click on this button until it's not orange. When it's orange, it's in pattern mode and will only play whatever's in your pattern. If you turn it off, it's going to play everything in the playlist. Let's go to pattern 2. Let's start with our hi-hat rhythm. Now we haven't introduced any advanced techniques yet. It's very computerized sounding because we didn't really use any advanced techniques. So let's right click, fill each 2 steps. And let's just left click and sequence a hi-hat pattern. Now this is very computerized and locked into the grid, we say. So it's not humanized. So let's go to our mixer. Let's start turning stuff down. Like our hi-hats don't need to be that loud. Now it's an okay rhythm to start. You know, that kind of rhythm is supposed to sound quantized. But let's add some claps. Let's go to pattern 3. Let's add those claps on the 2 and the 4 beat. If you don't know what that means, turn on your metronome. Every time the metronome hits, it's one beat. 1, 1, 2. So let's put on the 2. 1, 2, 3, clap. Let's go back to playlist mode. Turn the orange button off. Left click and drag pattern 3 into the playlist. We have a very dancey vibe right now. And for the kick, I want to lower it in pitch so it sounds a little beefier. So let's click on the kick, go to your pitch, pull this down. so it hits a little harder. Now let's see what this percussion sounds like. So I wanted to go boom and two and three and four and let's go to pattern four, add it to your playlist. Now for the metal percussion, we're gonna put it on the ands. So an and is when you're counting beats, one and two and three and four and. So it's one beat, two beat, three beat, four beats, but in between it goes one and two and three and four and. Just like we say one Mississippi, two Mississippi. You know, there's gap, there's time in between a second. Same with the beats. So we're gonna add the cymbal on the and. So not on the downbeats, but on the in-between areas. That's gonna add a little more push-pull effect to the track. So the track we're gonna make is gonna sound very sequenced because this is for beginners. So I understand you need a step-by-step process. Once you learn the principles and skills of music production, you're gonna expand into bigger things than just these sequence type of sounds. But I understand as a beginner, you need a step-by-step process, and that's what we're here for at busyworksbeats.com/beginners. So now we need musicality to go behind the track. Let's go to FL Keys. Let's enter the pattern into the playlist. I'm gonna drag it out, however. And here you're just gonna have to follow along because describing music theory in one quick video is not gonna be ideal. Okay, so just, you're gonna have to follow along with the music theory here. So we're gonna start off on A minor, which is A, C, E. We're gonna use that as our root note. And then we're gonna go up an octave to the other A and then play A, C, E. Okay, now I'm gonna click on B, G, E, that's E minor. And then we're gonna add the bass note E down an octave. Then we're gonna go F, A, C, which is F major. F is the root note on the bass. And then we wanna hear A again, so it's D, F, A, which is D minor. And you don't have to worry about, again, the theory behind that. If you wanna learn more music theory, go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory will guide you through chord progressions, what scales are, what a melody is, bass lines, harmonies, everything, fifths, circles of fifths, all that. So now we have a full chord progression, this is called, for four bars. Let's X out of the piano roll, and it counts for four bars of our sequence. All we have to do, we're gonna kind of cheat here. We're gonna hit Control C to copy our MIDI from pattern five. Let's go to pattern six. Highlight FL Slayer, hit Control V. Click on the screen to pull up the piano roll. And we're gonna get rid of everything. We're gonna get rid of everything below the highest note. So just hit Control Shift to highlight the notes you don't want. Hit Delete. It only leaves us with one note. Let's go to our mixer and turn down the guitar. Track, where are we at? Track 10. So let's go to our mixer, go to track 10, turn it down because it's going to be loud. Let's insert pattern 6 into the playlist. Let's click here, select pattern 6, left click and add it to the playlist. So that's our first loop. We created a loop. So to make this into more of a song structure, I'm not going to go over full song structure. Just type in song structure, Busyworks Beats. If you want to learn more about that. But we need to make the song evolve over time. So let's pull the guitar part over here somewhere. Let's hit Shift, left click and duplicate it. Let's highlight everything, hitting Control, left click and drag, hold Shift, pull it over, Shift, Shift again. And for the piano, I'm gonna insert a bass octave. So let's click here. We're gonna make this unique so it makes it a new pattern. Let's click here and go to edit. What I'm gonna do is add another bass octave. So let's highlight all the bass notes, hit shift, left click and highlight, and hit control down. I'm gonna insert, that's gonna pull it down another octave. So now we get that bitey bass. So it adds a little more power to the chord progression. So it goes lightweight, then it goes powerful. So we could do the same thing. We have to change this to pattern 6. So let's click here in the top left, go to select source pattern, pattern 6. And let's go back to our playlist, make sure it's not orange. And then let the song build up naturally. Now if you want to make it build up even more, make the first pattern unique. Let's go to edit pattern and delete the bass notes so that you only play what's called a triad, a 3-note chord. Now we need to make the beat sound better. That's where mixing comes into play. Down a little bit more. Track 10. So I'm going to quickly go over mixing. I'm not going to overly do it because you can learn a lot more about how to mix beats easily at busyworksbeats.com. We have a course called How to Mix Beats Easily. You could also Google it if you want to find the link. Let's focus on our kick. I'm gonna right click to solo it. Or I'm not gonna solo, but anyway, let's go to slot 1. Let's open up parametric EQ 2. Let's use 0.2, pull it up around 100 hertz or so. Gives a little more thump. Now we want to pan the hi-hat. We don't have to necessarily, but everything's centered. So in mixing, you want stuff to be spread out so you can actually hear it. So let's pan that slightly, the hi-hat, to the left. And let's pan this other bell percussion on track 3 to the right. So it balances out high frequency with high frequency. So all we're doing is panning and setting the levels. We're not doing much else. And for the piano, it sounds a little... let's say digital. So let's go to track 100. This is a little more advanced, but I want to show you what an aux track is. So if you go to track 100, these are dedicated auxes. Let's call this aux reverb. You can learn a lot more at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. Let's open up Fruity Convolver and let's turn down the dry level. Now here we can load up, my preamp makes the air really dry. So sorry about that. Anyway, we can load up real environments and load them into this impulse response reverb so that when we run sounds through here, they'll sound like they're coming through those real environments. So let's load up, let's go to file, load sample. We could choose from different environments. Let's go to a hall and then let's go to St. Paul's. I'm just clicking on random stuff. So it's gonna load up this sample, okay? Don't hit play, or it might be really loud. Just X out. What we wanna do now is send tracks from the left side to this aux track. So to do that, we click on tracks we want to have reverb on, like our piano, track 9. Let's left click on it. You'll see these up arrows over here. All we do is just left click this knob to send it to an aux send. So the more I send it, the more reverb you're gonna hear. It makes it more realistic. So let's send more elements to that reverb. Let's click on the guitar track, left click this up arrow, send it to the reverb. So it sounds like it's in that same environment. Same with our claps. Let's send clap 1 through that same reverb. Brings our mix alive a little bit. It makes it feel real. Now this is a little more advanced, but for the piano, we're going to add Fruity Compressor. If you want to learn more about compression, again, we explain this in our Mixing Academy, right at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. But we also have a beginner's mixing course called How to Mix Beats Easily. I'd suggest that first. But if you want to get into the more advanced stuff, you can go there. Anyway, so we're going to lower our threshold to about negative 20 dB, give it at zero tack, and then our ratio 4:1 if you just want to follow along. Let's give it a tack of about 20 milliseconds. We're going to pull the makeup gain so the volume is restored. If you want to exaggerate it, pull your threshold down. If you can't hear the compression, you could always hear what it's doing by pulling down the threshold, adding like a little click energy to the piano. Can do to make the song evolve is get rid of stuff. So let's get rid of pattern 3, which is our claps. We can right click to delete. So it's just the snare. Let's EQ, let's add a parametric EQ 2 to the snare. Let's pull up frequency 3. Add a little bottom to the snare. Let's also add a fruity compressor. Lower the threshold to negative 20, pull up the ratio to about 2:1. So that's how you make a beat in short. I'm not going to take it further because I might confuse you with other concepts. But again, we guide you through all the phases of music production right at busyworksbeats.com/beginners. You can learn all the phases of music production and what you're going to need to make your beats sound better. So you have to start with the easy stuff first to get used to the program. And that's what we guide you through right at busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. I'll leave all those links below so you don't get confused. But thank you for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.
Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit busyworksbeats.com/music theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at busyworksbeats.com/mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at busyworksbeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.